Today I'm showing you how I painted this zebra in acrylics. I got my zebra stripes roughly painted in. Now I'm working on the giant rock behind him, and I'm holding my brush loosely between two fingers as I do this. So my hand is kind of shaky. This helps make my lines ragged without putting in too much extra effort. I'm blending the edges of these shadows in the rocks with my mop brush and being careful not to cover up the cracks that are already there. These lighter shadows also need to be softly blended. In the meantime, the defined edge of the shadow along his back leg shows where that connects to his rear end. And by making these stripes curved, I'm showing the roundness of his belly. The stripes can't be just solid black. You'll see more of that when we get to the color portion of this video, but for now, you're seeing me go over the stripes on his back with a lighter gray to show that light is hitting this part of the zebra's body. Now we get to the color portion. I'm mixing transparent mixing white, burnt umber, and cadmium red deep, and I'm painting that in a sheer wash all over the rock. I'm putting out yellow, magenta, and ultramarine blue. First, I'm mixing some magenta into the yellow to make orange. Then I'm mixing some of the titanium white that's already onto my palette into this so it's as light as I want it to be. Now you might remember me saying that the stripes can't be solid black. So I'm painting blue over some of these stripes to show that light is hitting this part of the zebra's body. For the stripes that will be solid black, I want to make sure they're nice and intense. In the meantime, I'm putting another layer on the rock. And because white things reflect colors around them, I'm bringing some of that pink I just used into my zebra. These are going to be barely there, almost ghostly blue shadows that I'm painting on the rock. As soon as I put a few strokes down, I'm blending the edges out with a mop brush. I have a lot less water in my paint for the cracks, because I want them to be more solid. And again, I'm using just the tip of my liner brush and holding it loosely between my two fingers, just like when I was doing the underpainting. Sometimes when you're painting, you'll put something down, decide it's completely wrong, and go over it. And that's what you see me doing here. He has a dark red shadow along his jaw. Now, even though this shadow is dark, it still needs to be sheer, and it still needs to be blended. Otherwise, it's not a shadow, it's a red splotch. The shape of this shadow also indicates the roundness of his jaw. These shadows feathering out show how he's extending this leg. And again, this shadow along the edge shows the shape of the leg. Can't forget his tail. It's wrapped around him and super fluffy, as you can see, and I'm making sure my strokes are curved. Okay, so the rock in the background isn't one big mass. It's more like three separate rocks joined together. And so I need to make the vertical shadows on it darker so you can see that separation more. And also need some darker pink shadows. If you liked this video, you might also like this one I did of a reindeer walking. Remember to subscribe so I can help you bring out your creativity. Thanks for watching.